Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel all about electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the exponential Fourier series. And in this video, we will discuss the following topics. So in the previous video, we have discussed the trigonometric Fourier series and we had seen that using this trigonometric Fourier series, any periodic signal can be represented by the linear combination of the sine and the cosine waves. So this exponential Fourier series is another way of representing the periodic signal. And in this exponential Fourier series, the periodic signal is represented by the linear combination of the complex exponentials. So if we have a one periodic signal g of t with a time period t, then mathematically it can be expressed as the linear combination of the complex exponentials, where this omega naught is equal to 2 pi divided by t. And here this n is varying from minus infinity to plus infinity. And here, this cn is the coefficients of this complex exponentials. Now for this representation to be valid, these complex exponentials have to be the orthogonal signals, right? So let us quickly recall what we had seen in the previous video. So in the previous video, we had seen the concept of the orthogonality. And we had seen that the two signals are said to be orthogonal if this condition gets satisfied. And during our discussion, we have assumed that the two signals g of t and the x of t are real signals. But if these signals are the complex signals, then they are said to be orthogonal when any of these condition gets satisfied. Where here, this asterisk represents the complex conjugate of the signal. That means when we multiply the one signal with the complex conjugate of the another signal, and integrate them over the finite time, and if that integration comes to zero, then we can say that the two signals are orthogonal over the finite time. Then after, we had also seen, if we have a complete set of orthogonal signals, then using such set, any signal g of t can be represented by the linear combination of these orthogonal signals. And using this expression, we can find the different coefficients. But if the orthogonal signals are the complex signals, then there will be a slight change in this expression. So instead of that signal x of t, there will be a complex conjugate of that signal. So in this exponential Fourier series, this term is the complex exponential. And these complex exponentials are the orthogonal signals. So let's say we have two signals. One signal is e to the power j n omega naught t, and another signal is e to the power j m omega naught t. So for this signal to be orthogonal, either of this condition should get satisfied. And here this omega naught is equal to 2 pi divided by t. So for this signal to be orthogonal, this integration 0 to t g of t times x star of t dt should be equal to 0. Or we can say that integration 0 to t e to the power j n omega naught t times e to the power minus jm omega naught t dt should be equal to 0. And to check that, first of all let us integrate this term. So we can write this expression as integration 0 to t e to the power j times n minus m omega naught t dt. So here we are assuming that both n and m are different, and also we are assuming that this n is greater than m. So if we integrate this term, then we can write it as e to the power j times n minus n omega naught t divided by j times n minus m times omega naught. And over here, the integration limit will be from 0 to t. So if we put this integration limit, then we can write it as 1 divided by j times n minus n times omega naught times e to the power j times n minus m times 2 pi divided by t times this t minus e to the power 0, that is equal to 1. So here if we solve this expression, then we will get e to the power j times n minus m times 2 pi. So here as n minus m is integer, so this exponential will be the integer multiple of the 2 pi. And because of that, its value will be equal to 1. That means if we see the entire equation, then it will be equal to 1 divided by j times n minus m times omega naught times 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. So indeed, this integration is equal to 0. And hence, we can say that when both n and m are different, then this g of t and the x of t or these complex exponentials are the orthogonal signals. But suppose if n is equal to m, in that case, this integration will be equal to 0 to t e to the power j times n omega naught t times e to the power minus j times n omega naught t dt. So this term will be equal to e to the power 0 and hence it is equal to 1. That means this integration will get simplified to integration 0 to t 1 times dt, that is equal to t. That means whenever this n is equal to m, then this integration is equal to t. So from this we conclude that when both m and n are different, then these complex exponentials are the orthogonal, and when m is equal to n, then this integration is equal to t, where this n is varying from minus infinity to plus infinity. So in this exponential Fourier series, since these complex exponentials are the orthogonal signals, so the any signal g of t can be represented by the linear combination of these orthogonal signals. And the coefficient of these orthogonal signals or these complex exponentials can be found using this expression. So here, this xn of t is equal to e to the power j times n omega naught t. So from this, we can write this expression cn as cn is equal to integration 0 to t g of t e to the power minus j times n omega naught t times dt divided by this x of t whole square times dt. Now if we just take the magnitude of this x of t or this complex exponential, then it is equal to 1. And hence, this integration will be equal to t. That means we can say that this coefficient cn is equal to 1 by t times integration 0 to t g of t times e to the power minus j times n omega naught t times dt, where omega naught is equal to 2 pi divided by t. So in this way, we can find the coefficients of these complex exponentials. Now here, unlike the trigonometric Fourier series, the coefficient cn could be complex number. But whenever this signal g of t is real, then the pair of cn and the c minus n will be complex conjugate. So let us see how. So as we have seen, this cn can be given by this expression. And c of minus n can be given as 1 by t integration 0 to t g of t e to the power j times n omega naught t times dt, right? Now let us take the complex conjugate of this integration. So if we take the complex conjugate, then we can write it as 1 by t integration 0 to t g of t e to the power minus j times n omega naught t times dt, right? Because here, since the signal g of t is real, so it will remain as it is. And if you see this expression, then it is equal to cn. That means for the real signal, this cn and the c of minus n are the complex conjugate. So for the complex conjugate, this amplitude will be same. That means cn and the c minus n will have the same amplitude, but their phase will be opposite. For example, if we take the complex number a plus jb, then its complex conjugate is equal to a minus jb, right? And if you see the amplitude of both complex numbers, then it is equal to square root of a square plus b square. But if you see the phase of this a plus jb, then it will be equal to tan inverse b divided by a, while for this a minus jb is equal to minus of tan inverse of b by a. So if we plot the magnitude of cn at the different frequencies, then it will be the even function. On the other end, if we plot the phase of this coefficient at the different frequencies, then it will be the odd function. But this is only valid when the signal g of t is real signal. Alright, so far we have proved that the complex exponentials are the orthogonal signals, and if the signal g of t is real signal, then the coefficient of this pair cn and the c minus n are the complex conjugate. So in this exponential Fourier series, we are representing the signal by the linear combination of the complex exponentials, while in the trigonometric Fourier series, the signal was represented by the linear combination of the sine and the cosine wave. But since we are representing the same signal, so there has to have some relation between the two Fourier series. So now let us find the relation between the coefficients of this trigonometric and the exponential Fourier series. And to find that, let us expand this summation. So here, we will write the positive and the negative coefficients together. So if we expand this summation, then we can write it as C0 plus C1 times e to the power j omega naught t plus C minus 1 times e to the power minus j omega naught t. Similarly, if we write the second term, then it will be equal to C2 times e to the power j times 2 omega naught t plus C of minus 2 times e to the power minus j times 2 omega naught t. And likewise, if we write the nth term, then it will be equal to Cn times e to the power j times n omega naught t plus C of minus n times e to the power minus j times n omega naught t. Right? So for a moment, here let us just focus on this nth term. And here, we can write this term as cos of n omega naught t plus j times sin n omega naught t. Similarly, we can write this exponential as cos of minus n omega naught t, that is equal to cos of n omega naught t minus j times sin n omega naught t. So if we just combine the sine and the cosine terms, then we can write it as cn plus c minus n times cos of n omega naught t plus j times cn minus c minus n times sin n omega naught t. And if we compare this nth term with the nth term of this trigonometric Fourier series, then we can write it as this an is equal to cn plus c minus n, while the bn is equal to j times cn minus c minus n. And of course, here a0 is equal to c0. And of course, by solving these two expressions, we can find the coefficient cn and the c minus n in terms of the an and the bn. So if we do so, then this cn can be written as 1 by 2 times an minus j times bn, while c minus n is equal to 1 by 2 times an plus j times bn. So in this way, we found the relationship between the coefficients of this trigonometric and the exponential Fourier series. Now in this exponential Fourier series, the coefficients of these complex exponentials are getting added in such a way that we are getting the real signal. And to understand that, let us just consider the nth and the minus n term of this exponential Fourier series. So here, this cn will have amplitude as well as the phase. So we can write this cn in this fashion. That is cn times e to the power j phi. Similarly, this c of minus n can be written as c minus n times e to the power minus j phi. And since the amplitude of cn and the c minus n are same, so we can write it as cn times e to the power minus j phi. So from this, we can write this expression as cn times e to the power j phi times e to the power j times n omega naught t plus cn times e to the power minus j n omega naught t times minus e to the power minus j phi. That is equal to cn times e to the power j times n omega naught t plus phi plus e to the power minus j times n omega naught t plus phi. That is equal to 2 times cn times cos of n omega naught t plus phi. So here, n and the minus nth coefficients of these complex exponentials are getting added in such a way that they are representing the sinusoidal signal of the nth harmonic. And the same is also true for the other coefficients. And when we combine all these different harmonics, then it is possible to represent the periodic signal g of t. Alright, so now let us understand the concept of the negative frequency. So when we represent the signal using this exponential Fourier series, then we always come across the negative frequency, particularly when we are representing these coefficients of these exponentials. But whenever we are representing the signal using this trigonometric Fourier series, then we never come across the negative frequency, right? So in this exponential Fourier series, we are getting the negative frequencies because of these complex exponentials. So for a moment, if we neglect this coefficient cn, then this complex exponential e to the power j times n omega naught t represents the phasor of the unit length. And this phasor is rotating in the counterclockwise direction. And here, since its frequency is equal to n times f naught, it means that it completes n times f naught rotations in 1 second. Similarly, this complex exponential, that is e to the power minus j times n omega naught t, also represents the unit length phasor which is rotating in the clockwise direction. So here, this negative sign only indicates the direction of the rotation. But if you see the frequency of this complex exponential, then still it is equal to n times f naught. So as I said earlier, this positive and the negative complex exponentials are getting added in such a way that they are actually representing the real signal. So in this frequency spectra of this exponential Fourier series, whenever we find the coefficient for this negative frequency, then it indicates that that particular complex exponential is present in the given representation. So the question arises, when we already have the trigonometric Fourier series, then what is the use or what is the importance of this exponential Fourier series? Well, the thing is, this exponential Fourier series is useful in understanding the Fourier transform. So far we had seen that any periodic signal can be represented using the Fourier series. But if the signal is not periodic, then such signals can be represented using the Fourier transform. So in the upcoming videos, we will talk about the Fourier transform. And on the basis of this exponential Fourier series, we will understand the Fourier transform. So I hope in this video, you understood the exponential Fourier series. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.